There once was a flock that was lost and afraid. They wandered around Cleveland without directions for days. The Lord looked down with compassion from above and changed Robert Williams to lead them with love. The shepherd was kind, loving, and wise, and cherish his whole flock, no matter the color or the size. Though the shepherd was small, humble, and meek, every ear listened whenever he was speaking. He showed them the way to walk in the light, and he prayed every day, "Lord, help Jason to get right." I thought y'all liked it.
Say it, boy, say it.
The blood of the Lamb and above the Creator, the blood of the Lamb and about the Creator, which is the great I Am. They flourished and they grew through the knowledge they gained about the Savior from above, who lived without blemish or stain. The flock was so grateful to the Lord up above for sending a wise leader who was so full of love. He led them with a strong and gentle hand and took the whole flock safely into God's promised land. Amen. Like I said, this is Pastor Appreciation Month. We're going to celebrate it today. This is Pastor Priest Month. And to Bishop and Evangelist, I hope you have fun. I'm Jason Austin, and my work is done. Thank you for your time. I'm going home, but you won't be by yourself. I'm going to leave you alone.
Of Bishop and Evangelist, because it was something that I really needed. I needed that structure, and I needed that truly solid foundation. And I must say, it's nice to be able to go to your pastor and say, Pastor, I need to talk about this, or to call Evangelist and say, I need you to pray for me. I need this. I need, and they stop what they're doing to help you, you know. Now, before I came here, I was at the Word Church. I can't ever remember a time where I was able to call my pastor and say, I need to talk, or I need you to pray for me, or I need help with this or help with that. I was never able to do that, you know? And then when I came here and I saw the anointing over my pastors, I was like, that's where I want to be. That's what I want for myself and for my family, you know? And I just want to say thank you for allowing God to use you. Thank you for denying yourselves and truly living within your spirit and being that example that we need.
Amen.
And I'm truly thankful for that, you know? And, you know, it even goes further as in, you know, our prayer, you know, our worship, really not caring what your neighbor has to say, you know, not caring, knowing that you're there to worship God, mm-hmm. who has been your all in all, who has been there when no one else has, it's been really meaningful to me, you know. And you know, like I said once before, not long ago, God truly brought me to my knees, you know. You know, it's easy to come in these doors every Sunday and just sit. And just go through the motions. And you hear it, but then it's like, you know, it's kind of going over your head. But you know, when God really sits you down and he say, daughter, I got a word for you. And he ain't playing. When you ain't got no choice but to be still.
Come on.
It changed my life. It really changed my life. And it changed my life for the better. And I'm going to tell you, I dropped to my knees and I cried and I prayed and I cried and I prayed. And through it all, I can say, thank you, Lord, for surrounding me with godly people. Because that's a huge part that people don't understand. You know, when you're in the process of changing your life and living the way that God wants you to, you have to surround yourself with godly people.
Right.
You know, because it's very true that some battles we don't have to fight.
Come on, that's true.
But when we put ourselves in those situations, we have a responsibility. You know, people can easily say, oh, well, God won't allow this or God won't allow that. It don't work like that, sisters and brothers. Because God has also given us a discernment of right and wrong and given us the responsibility to make a choice. Now, people say, you ain't got no choice. Oh, you always got a choice. No matter what the situation is, you always got a choice. And it's on the choice you make. You know, what I had to truly start doing was when I get up in the morning, saying, thank you, Lord, for allowing me another journey in you. Got my kids to the point where before they go get on that bus, they come. Mommy, we got to pray.
Amen. That's right.
We got to get our covering before we leave up out of here. You understand? And when you do that, when you have that covering, it means so much. You know, it truly means so much in knowing that you got all these different people praying for you and, you know, just really supporting you. It's meaningful. And this is what I want to continue to have. Godly people surrounding me. The love of each and every one of you. Yeah, I ain't got on no heels today. You know, I got my flats on today in case I had to shout, you know. But, God is good. God is really good. And, you know, I'm truly thankful. I'm really, you know, and I, believe me, it's not that I'm taking away from my pastor and first lady, you know, because I'm thankful for them. But most of all, I'm thankful to God.
All right.
Because he's the one that put them in my life to lead and help direct me. You know what I'm saying? To teach me, to increase my knowledge and my wisdom within God that only can come from him.
Amen.
You know?
Amen.
Grace that I can only find from my father. For my first lady to be that example. For my pastor to always be teaching. No matter what. You come to him and ask him just a regular question, he gonna teach you. Okay? Try playing a game with him. Okay? He gonna ask, well, who said?
Yeah.
If it ain't in the Constitution. Okay? But I'm thankful for that, you know, because that's love. You know, and I thank God for allowing his spirit to shine through them. And I thank God most of all for truly changing me. Because for a long time, I was definitely caught up in the world.
You know,
living my life, not for God, but for the world, you know. And knowing I had that foundation, but like so many of us, we tend to go astray a bit, you know. But when God calls you back, and he lets you know, I got you. You know, because I don't know about nobody else, but I don't know, I've been able to hear my You know, when I've been wondering about how I'm going to do this or how I'm going to do that, you know, I can hear him saying, daughter, I got a word for you. And being able to truly stand on his word, you know, because that's something that is, it's very important, being able to stand on his word, to live and to truly be obedient. You know, it's what Bishop has been, you know, teaching us about for a long time. And it was like, okay, I got it. I finally hear. You know, because the thing is that in the Constitution,
okay,
it says that if you live your life for me and you are truly obedient, I will give you your heart's desire. Now, see, y'all should have just shouted right there.
Okay.
Right there. Because he's telling us, I will give you what your heart desires.
Yes, yes, yes.
But we got to be, we got to make it hard. We got to try to do it our way.
All right.
But I thank God because he always brings us back and lets us know, I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am the beginning and the end, okay? And when he does that, and you hear him, and you simply be still to hear his voice, and when you have the direction of a good pastor, first lady, that is not only teaching you how to live, but teaching us how to truly be on one accord with the word, and living our life accordingly, it makes a difference. And I'm thankful for that. I really am, because I can't say to you that if I was still at the word, that I would be where I am today. See, you know, it all makes sense. You know, everything that happens, you got to understand, it's not by chance and it's not by circumstance. Everything goes according to the way God wants it to go. Every situation, every person we come in contact with, everything that we do is a reason. But as long as we're truly able to give thanks and glorify God throughout, we're going to be okay. Because no matter what, when she was talking about, you know, the benefits this morning, I opened my letter this morning, they say denied. I say, but that's okay. Because if my father say, it's going to be, it's going to be.
Yes.
I used to worry like you. But I had to give that up because it wasn't going to add one more minute, one more second to my life. And I have to truly stand on his word and what he said that he will do for me and what he has been doing for me. Because I got some stories. He done brought me out of a lot. Okay? A lot. Loved me when I didn't love myself, okay? So, you know, for me to stand before you today and, you know, say all of these things, I'm not ashamed, you know, of where I've been or what I've been through, because it's all my testimony. And I just want to say I love you guys, and I love my pastor tremendously. And I, anytime, Dad, what you need me to do? Mom, what you need me to do? And I mean that wholeheartedly, because you are a blessing to me and to my family. And
amen.
I give thanks to God for you.
Amen.
And I love you.
Explaining the word in detail.
us excited.
We
excited. Loving us.
Okay.
Allowing other pastors to pray for us.
Yeah.
Celebrating. We love and appreciate you.
Something that my uncle told me when I had my child. And 2 days later, I had my first niece. And my mother was the one that babysitted for us. And my niece and my daughter were laying there, and it was his first time coming to see them. And he said to me, "Hey, your baby looks the best." And he said, "And you know something else?" I said, "What?" He said, "Your baby is something special. That she's going to be something special." He knew what he was talking about then, because I would not have known that my baby would be one of God's messengers today.
Amen.
All right.
And I thank him for that. But then it came back over me, and last week and this week, and I was talking to my baby, and I told her the words that he had told me. I said, "But you know something else?" I said, "Nobody would never have known that my uncle was special also."
All right. Mm-hmm. All right.
It took me back to when my sister had fell down the stairs. And when she fell down the stairs with us playing on the stairs, nobody knew that she was seriously hurt. Mm. But later on, she went and she sat down. And when she sat down, then she had this weird look about her and she started to cry. And we knew that she had them fell down the stairs about a half an hour before. And she didn't seem like she was hurt. But when my mother said something to her, she started to cry more because she didn't know who my mother was. Then we all came around, and my aunt, Big Johnny Mae, my mother called her. She came over. She didn't know who she was. Then my mother asked her, "Say, well, what is your name?" And she said, "Rose Greer." Okay, so we knew that it was something seriously wrong with her. My mother took her to the hospital, and they told her that she had amnesia. Only person that she could think of was my Uncle Robert. She knew who he was, and she knew his name. Mm-hmm. But, see, God was in the midst of that because he was still overseas, but he had came home on leave. Mm. And just at that particular time that she was calling on him, he was home. Mm. My mother called my grandma, and she told her, so my grandma and my Uncle Robert, they came through the door. When they came through the door, she jumped up off the couch and ran to him and started hugging him. And she knew who he was then. But she still didn't know nobody else. So that let us know there. We should have seen he was something special.
Yes. Yes.
And you know, everybody, God has something in everybody's heart and mind where all of us are special. But we are special in a special way.
Right.
And so I just want to read just a little of what's going on here and how I feel about my aunt and my uncle. Because I truly know they are special. And when they came into the hall on Friday, and I seen him crying, seeing the tears shed of joy. And I was talking to my aunt. I told her, I said, you know what? I said, he made me want to cry too. I said, she said, that's the love that you all share with each other. And then we started reminiscing on when I was a young girl and my mother would cry. I didn't know what the tears was for, but I didn't want to see her cry. So she would be in her room sitting on her bed, and I would go and sit on the floor beside her bed and have my head leaning over her leg. I would be crying with her because I felt hurt because I seen her crying. And I still have those same feelings for each and every one of my loved ones.
All right.
And first I want to read about our pastor. Our pastor has a thankless job in many different ways. Mm-hmm. He gets a lot of helpful hints, but gets so little praise. The time he has is not his own. He's not like other men. Right when he thinks some time is this, is his, there rings that phone again. Someone is sick or needs advice and asks for him to call. And as God's man, they know he'll come and hardly mind at all. The wisdom of King Solomon revealed throughout each day to lead his flock and keep them safe from Satan's cunning ways. Like Jesus, he prays for his sheep, prays faith will never dim. But when we lift our prayers to God, how many pray for him? So let's be faithful to that one who helps us day by day. Let's not forget our man of God when we kneel down to pray.
Amen. Amen.
And I was always taught where there is a good man and always a good woman by his side. The pastor's wife. She's a godly woman. She has such grace. Always a warm greeting with a smile on her face. She's always encouraging. She knows her place. She is the pastor's wife. She has to always look just right. Always on time, though the schedule is tight. From early morning to late at night, always the pastor's wife. She's such a lady, everyone's friend. She serves with love from deep within.
All right.
All the rifts she tries to mend, oh, she's the pastor's wife. Yeah. She carries your burdens, she prays for you. Sometimes she cries the whole night through. But you won't know when she's feeling blue, because she's the pastor's wife.
All right.
At churches, she starts to walk up the aisle. So many need to stop and talk for a while. Though she is tired, she has her own trials. She's patient. She's the pastor's wife. Her life, her time is not her own. There's always a need. They go on and on. With a knock at the door or a ringing phone, that's the life of the pastor's wife. Her husband she shares with the whole congregation. She humbly accepts his intense dedication. In loneliness, she kneels to seek consolation. God bless the pastor's wife. She will someday reach the end of this race as she meets her master face to face. Surely our God has a special place in heaven for the pastor's wife.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah, everybody come get your bounce on, get your bounce on. Your big you with it, you gotta get caught. Just one. Your big you with it, you gotta get caught. Just one. don't want to hear the rumors.
I'm haunting on the street. Yeah, I'm a Lord. Thank you.